Mondak, you begin to peel the bookcase back. You know, that day, all of a sudden, you know, you're hit with a wall of dust.
Yeah. I have asthma.
And I'd like a spot check from you. You're technically. Did you walk
there? Spot, bro.
I like all five of us.
Everyone's in this room, but only Mondak and.
I'm not the one pointing at it. Then going over.
Carrick. Only Mondak and Carrick.
7 plus 17 plus.
Get your own damn dice. I paid money for these.
Shit.
But those ones are lucky.
They were touched by you.
So Mondak. You notice this. Now, of course, the remaining three, Syroth, Beodane, and Buford, you guys are just sort of in the room, the library.
Yeah.
And, so Mondak notices that there's, inside this room, there's a bunch of bookshelves with, like, tomes and, like, rituals and strange things. And you also notice there's, like, this thing called, like, the Priests of Osibus, you know, the priests of Osibus. It's some sort of...
They just chilling in there, or...?
No, it's, like, books for
Yo,
them.
Yo, what up?
Like,
oh, you freed me.
Rituals and stuff like that. You see there's a heavy wooden chest with clawed iron feet.
You get three
And, but you see...
The mind
inside the room, there's a body.
That's mine.
Alive?
No,
far from it. It's a skeleton.
I'm gonna shoot an arrow at it.
Is it okay?
Is it spooky?
Oh, it's spooky.
Should we still shoot an
arrow
at it?
It's
it's full spooky.
It's clad in dried out and ruined leather armor. But there, with your inspection, you notice there's darts.
Was he smoking? Okay, guys, seriously.
Can I loot them?
You can if you want. But there are darts in the corpse.
Oh, never mind.
In the corpse.
Please realize.
And you see there's something in its hand.
A lighter?
Piece of paper.
We're gonna murder you by the time this night is up.
Okay.
The arrow slowly draws towards
that Mondak.
I ready my most powerful spell.
Yes, there is a letter with a seal on it in this individual's hands.
The poke.
Skeleton mummified hands.
Okay. Well, obviously there's darts going to come out of the walls, like in Indiana Jones.
Probably.
Can I spell this?
Can I spell this? I don't know. What's your highest level of education? I only passed third grade.
Can I walk into the room?
2 years
well,
of university.
That's
shit.
I'm walking in the
board. I've learned nothing.
That's fair.
Can I do like a... Can I like look for like holes in the wall for where the darts come out?
Sure, yes.
Like plates?
Mm-hmm.
Grade 1 education.
Am I allowed to move in?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's my quality shit. Alright. Hold on. Do I have insight?
Investigation.
I've got two insight.
Investigation.
Oh,
investigation.
Yes.
Yeah, no, you don't.
Shit.
Four.
Nope.
Alright,
I'm got nada. Just
you're just sort of poking around, like, you know, lifting up, like, old tomes and stuff. You're just like,
I've got an item that's perfect for this.
Okay.
I take out my small bag of sand, which I got from the first campaign.
Okay.
And I throw it at the skeleton, triggering any pressure plates that it might have stepped on.
Okay. Nothing happens.
Shit. You sacrificed a good bag of sand.
You just take out this little pouch of sand, you're just like...
And you look like an idiot,
In fact, it sort of, you know, bounces off its head, and you hear, like, it's just like
the jaw kind of like
fall
off.
The infernal reef comes out of it.
I was going to say, Carrick walks in, just looks at you, throws but it's
small
it's
bag
dead.
Of sand is the only thing.
Yeah,
oh,
so
it's dead.
Carrick,
I'm trying to trigger traps.
Triggered. Can I do an investigation?
Yeah, you investigate. Otherwise, I'm teleporting to the skeleton.
I got a total of 11.
You find where the darts originated from. You perceive that the trap is broken. Long broken.
Oh, okay.
I think you took my pencil.
I found a clue.
It's okay. Can I? Is there any way I can like, get open up where it would load and see if it has any doors left? Because if it's broken, it might have stopped.
I think you need to stop the call.
Stop being so sensitive. All right, I'll no, walk
that's
up
like
to
two
the
holes
skeleton
in the wall. Not from what you notice. So as these the two check out the room, what would you three like?
I run across the room and grab the paper.
Hey man, I was doing.
So you just sort of sprint in.
I just sprint in and grab it.
Doesn't even know the paper's okay. There. Just.
I hope it's another.
Well, no, I walk in and then you guys were talking, so I would be able to hear it.
All
right. Well, that's like another curse. No one mentioned the paper.
So what would you two like to do after you steal the paper?
My God, mine.
I really want him to get out of curse.
Nudes.
Nudes.
Yold.
Yo, yeah. Look at thy breast.
Describe to me what you're wearing.
Improper ankles.
Right now, I'm just waiting for us to be distracted, and James gets the two kids kill us.
Probably.
They're gone, man. They're not even real.
Right. I raise my warhammer and I kill everyone. No. I'll do a.
What, the nudes? No, we just got real ones nowadays.
I don't get many nudes. I just watch porn.
So I'll do another spot check of the room, I guess.
So, okay, so like the woman the like grandson is there.
What is it?
And
one.
you're blinded by the dust. You start
my eyes are closed.
Like, cool.
Whatever. You're actually give yourself ulcers on your irises
and
you're like
he's eating pudding.
And,
his pants are off and he's watching Tubin Binu on the fucking like YouTube. Right? And I'm like, and I'm just here with a bowl of a shepherd's pie. I'm like, I'm not one to say something bad about somebody with their pants down in front of the computer, but you're only eating pudding.
So, Syroth, you have a letter in your hand with a seal on it.
I burn it. No.
Burn
you
everything.
D&D. You would
burn down the gate.
I know. I
burn
James
down
James
the gate.
That whole campaign would fall apart, and James would
yeah,
not
like takes
that.
Out a real note. It's like burn down the gate. It's like,
hey, do you want to burn it?
I
the quiver on the lip.
I walk. Hey, Mondak, look at this. And I open it facing him so that if there's a curse, it bounds onto him instead of me, and then I read it when it's done.
Now, as a warlock, I think he would have known what he was going to do. So, do you have any retorts?
No, he doesn't.
Before?
He's
a warlock. He's magical.
I'm a warlock.
Yeah, I'm quick.
First off, you would have to do an intelligence check because of that. Because, I mean, you're a fighter, right?
Fine.
Fighters
I open it
really
and read
magic.
It.
Alright.
Open it and read it.
Well, no, man. I'm fucking curious. I've already
curious George over here wants to see what's inside the letter.
I would let him see what's inside. Cautious.
Cautious George.
Cautious
Joe.
Cautious Henry.
So, you read the letter, and it's almost as if the letter reads to you.
Fucking curse.
And, but it's not like, oh, sorry. You can't lean back in the chair.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, because you're out of frame.
Am I?
Oh, no, everyone's good. It's just that the only complication would have been Wilson for leaning. So.
Don't lean.
the letter reads, my most pathetic servant. I am not a messiah sent to you by dark powers of this land. I have not come to lead you on a path to immortality. However, many souls you have bled on your hidden altar. However many visitors you have tortured in your dungeon. Know that you are not the ones who brought me to this beautiful land. You are but worms writhing in the in my earth. You say you are cursed. Your fortune spent. You abandoned love for madness. Took solace in the bosom of another woman. And sired a stillborn son, cursed by your darkness. Of that I have no doubt. Save you from your wretchedness, I think not. I prefer you as you are, your dread lord and master, Strahd von Zorovich.
Cool.
Yeah. Stamp.
So it does have a basement.
So,
I like the sign off. I like the sign off.
Is it loud or is it
love some kisses?
Only Daniel.
You are worms.
Love some kisses.
So it's a telepathic message.
Yeah,
it's
been good.
Yeah, so only Danny heard that message.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool. I already forgot all of it anyway.
What's written on that? Or hey, Syroth.
Sephiroth.
Hey, Sephiroth.
What's written on your katana there?
What's written on your,
what's my name?
Iceberg.
It's
a goddamn right.
This guy was like, I don't know, he was just like some underling or Strahd or something. Killed people. Thought that brought Strahd. Strahd was like, no, I'm here of my own accord. Before I drive a Honda, I'm, and, and then he's like, you're scum, I'm not gonna make you not scum, I like you as scum, keep doing scummy shit, and yeah.
And then it was Strahd out?
Strahd out, homie. Yeah. Right. So,
assembly.
Let's read this shit, because he might, also, like, they might know something about Strahd.
Yeah.
So is there anything else in the room you guys would like to check out?
I'm gonna take my crowbar,
look at it, read it myself.
Move to the side and pull it.
All right. So it's like this old oak chest, and you're just like, take your crowbar,
check.
Shove it in. You know, you crack the splinter.
Take the hammer.
Yeah, you splinter the wood. You take your hammer, and it's like, you know, it's
okay,
like
okay. Move to the side. Anything.
I didn't know the
new weapon skin. Legendary.
It's just the box just like comes up.
Hold on, mimics.
So, and inside.
Okay.
Inside this chest, you see three blank books with black leather covers. You see three spell scrolls. You see a strange paper that would be described as the deed to this house, and a deed to the windmill. And a signed will.
Get ready to party.
I think we just stole this from those kids.
Yes, that's what's in the chest.
Pretty much, yeah.
Can I take a look at the spell scrolls?
You don't know this.
Well, technically only he knows this.
I take them.
Damn it.
I pocket them.
Fuck. I'm going to sell them on eBay. No.
Meanwhile, so Devin will remember this.
Three books.
Yeah, three leather books.
Play the game
blank.
Of life now, baby.
This is the game of life.
You know,
Telltales.
This is your way of life.
Can I do a perception check right
Telltales
quick?
Telltales Monopoly.
Sure.
Telltales
Monopoly. three spell scrolls, of which you do not know yet. The deed to the house, the deed to the windmill, and a signed will.
Well,
is there a deed to the corpses inside of the windmill?
Real estate, baby.
It's real estate.
So, would there be anything Beaudain or Buford would like to do?
Well.
Oh, yes, and you rolled your thing?
Yeah.
What'd you roll?
I rolled a 9.
Plus?
That was oh.
Nothing changes.
No, there's nothing I really want to do, I guess. Or actually, can I inspect the skeleton?
Sure. We'll crawl up to the corpse.
Come on.
It triggers all the
show
traps.
Show me the money.
Mine.
20. 20. 20.
I think, you know, it's unfortunate that it was a 20. There's really nothing different about the skeleton that it hasn't been already uncovered.
And Wilson is now triggered.
It stays dead, but it's still our friend.
You just wasted a 20.
Yeah,
he died, but he remained.
The best friends
are
the ones that are dead, because they can't say you're not their friends.
Exactly.
He would have. Hey, man, you've had enough. He would have wanted me to have another drink.
So of course you guys are on the. You're on the second floor. Yes. Okay. So there's still.
I think we should look at some of these tomes, man. Like
no, tomes. Nothing in there. Nothing in the chest.
Yeah, tomes or other things that could have been found in this chest that.
It's. Oh, yeah, the chest. You look like a man as a former soldier. I've done a lot of wartime looting in my time, and you have the looks of one. But, anyway, I digress.
You look like a man who took some...
I got three blank books. I hand you one.
Right. You look like a man who
took
some
there are
to
tomes of, like...
So I hand you a blank book.
So are you inspecting the tomes?
Can you roll your...
There's to see that they, as a warlock, you know, this catches your eye quite quickly. It's, most of these tomes are about summoning fiends.
Ooh. Oh, most of them.
All of them.
Is that
the others are about gardening.
summoning herbs.
It's all about it's all about summoning fiends, the rituals, necromantic rituals of this cult, Minecraft. The priests of
They're about Hitler's lesser known love of knitting.
Oh yeah, I think
I understand in
there's nothing that catches your eye.
With the language, I also know script of.
Okay.
I also know script for.
Okay, but nothing catches your eye. Yeah.
Hold on. So it's like necromancy tomes.
Yeah, and fiend summoning tomes.
All right. So can I take all of them? Here, guys. I'll just hold on to these. These might have magical properties, which only I would be able to discern. Okay. So I'll just keep these in my bag.
Wait, what are those?
The blank book.
No, those are. He's talking about like the ones in the room.
No, in the secret room.
No.
He's talking about the books in the secret room, not the leather books.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, I thought that was the.
These are just like just a row of bookshelves in the secret room that are about tomes of necromantic.
Can I grab some of the fiend summoning ones?
Sure. How many?
Like three.
Sure.
And like two necromancy ones.
Sure.
Is there any on demons? Beodine.
No, just fiends in the necromancy.
So can I have a nice shape? Just description of the room again.
You see a heavy wooden chest clawed with iron feet. You had the good roll, right? No, you did not have the roll.
I didn't need the roll.
I had a pretty good roll.
But anyways, there's a skeleton in the room, an iron chest.
Is that open?
How many do this?
Is that one open?
Yes.
Like,
you see,
6 or 7?
I got a 20 before.
Okay. A skeleton in leather armor.
Listen to this.
It was a human. There's poison darts in it. Dart trap that was already triggered, no longer works. And the skeleton held a letter.
That you now hold.
That you now wield, yes.
Alright. Is this okay, James? Find me back with this.
I do believe everyone on the couch is gold.
Yeah, you're good as long as their fat heads are blocking you. They probably are.
Hey, man, I gotta store all that knowledge in there.
Half the time, they all gold.
It's big for a reason. Megamind 2016.
So
you are at a very high.
What would you guys like to do? Do
fully,
basically Megamind 2020.
Well, might as well go back to the library then, I guess.
That movie was better than Despicable Me.
You take one step out of the room door, you are now in the library.
I only saw it in theaters.
It was good.
Can I get a spell check at the library again? It's been a week.
Emo
give me my dice.
What was that one?
Yeah.
Ooh! You need like a roll bowl.
That was 8. No.
12 plus 4.
You see there's red velvet drapes that cover all the windows in this room. There's an exquisite mahogany desk matching with matching high-back chairs. You see there's a beautiful fireplace, a picture of a windmill perched atop a rocky crag. Situated in the corners of the room are overstuffed chairs, and floor-to-ceiling bookshelves line the wall. The south wall. And a rolling wooden ladder for the bookshelves.
Do any of the books really catch my eye if I look at them?
Let's say the books contain various, the history of dwarves, like in the 15th era or something like, just common stuff.
Yeah.
Like
nothing, right, nothing
family
smart.
History.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Turns out we're all dirty short people.
I had a sergeant when I was just a corporal in the army. He's a real dick, but he had a great mahogany desk in our outpost. So I'd like, and I hate mahogany, so I'd like to take my greatsword and draw a dick in it. Just carve a big dick in this mahogany desk.
Did you sell that for like, I don't know, like 20 gold? How much would mahogany desk be?
I think more than 20. Depending on, well, like,
performance.
Performance?
Depends
roll
on your
performance.
Economy at the time, I guess.
10 plus. What did that mean?
There's
dex?
Elf
no.
Well, that might
no.
Put
performance
the
is charisma.
It's an actual skill.
But it's not going to be me talking.
No, but
it's
a charisma. It's
one thing
like
I can see is
sleight of hand. Eventually went to Hank.
Right.
He was like, fine.
Sleight of hand.
Hank in 2022.
10 plus 2 then. 12.
Alright. Low. You carve a semi-decent shaft into the mahogany exquisite desk. So,
He was a dick.
Buford and Beodane, anything you'd like to do? Enthusiast. No, not really.
Sarah.
Alright, you're just gonna chill out in this room and just sort of wait until time ends and the sun engulfs the earth?
Yeah.
Okay.
Apparently, because that's
what you like, check.
They're getting engulfed and
check.
Come back.
Yeah.
Yo, Shaquille,
I've been fine 20 times
because you're infinitely years old. I'm 145.
Sweat like
150
feet tall, man.
Yeah.
Bitch. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm pretty sure, like, every dwarf, I'm pretty sure.
I just found that out, man. I thought he was, like, normal basketball player.
So you step into the hallway, and, I mean, obviously your objective is to sort of, you know, are the kids here? No. No kids.
Are they following us? Are they waiting to kill us?
No. But, you know, everything remains the same as a few minutes ago. You guys are still, you know, the armor is still in the corners. There's the stairway that goes up and goes down. Yeah.
There's so far
there's
no
a
basement.
Third floor. There's four floors.
I know, but so far no basement.
There is no
just
basement.
Just getting back onto our climbing objective
the top
was to find the basement.
The top floor was the basement.
Well,
wow.
So, why not?
Well, there was no, you guys did fully explore the first floor, so there was no staircase down, but only a staircase that goes up.
Was there
show
a
up
picture
to go.
Of the family? The
remember, Pirates of the Caribbean
yes,
logic,
there was
we gotta go up to go down.
In the main hallway, which you're standing
we gotta go
right
up to go down. Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End.
You've already used this joke.
Yeah.
I know, I used it last time. I'm referencing it.
Does the height of
the
stone keeping consistency?
No, I seriously think
22 years before it's funny again. That's the age joke standard in place by South Park.
Actually,
it takes 22 years for
no.
Eight.
I seriously think that the top of this building is going to be like a secret shaft that goes all the way down.
I'll show you. Yeah, don't remind him of our shaft.
No, I think there's like an elevator, like a dumbwaiter that goes all the way down to the basement. That's where the werewolves are.
A really big dumbwaiter.
A real dumbwaiter.
But what?
So,
the strongest of back and weakest of mind of the raiders.
So your
the Hodor
party member
Carrick
has entered the hallway. What would you guys like to do?
He's waiting for us at the top. He's going to carry us all the way back down.
I will enter the other hallway. No, I'll enter the hallway. I'll enter the hallway. Don't let anybody notice.
Main,
the 9 3
main job
hallway.
Is?
Harry Potter reference.
The hallway
he's their doorman.
Hallways. Do I have to roll for that entrance?
No. So, yes.
Unless you want to do a backflip or...
Get it?
Ooh, don't tempt me.
The doorman!
Because he holds the door.
So, what would you guys like to do?
Well,
some of your party members are in the hallway now.
Yeah, I guess go up?
I guess
no,
I'll go up with
no
him.
One even noticed you draw the dick.
You draw
so,
the dick
that's,
with thy
that's
noble sir.
That's a personal slight. Nobody has to notice it.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking dick.
So, yeah, you guys just go, you guys just go upstairs?
Yep.
I'm
not. Yeah, he's tomes.
Go up
for fiend summoning.
Okay.
In the back.
Guys,
in the magic
where'd you
game.
Go?
Hello.
You guys
this is
up.
Funny.
So,
the kids are back.
Who's going up the stairs to the third floor first?
Oh well.
Second last.
Right.
I guess I should. I'll switch my greatsword out for my glaive because it's probably if it's a staircase, it's gonna be kind of weird.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All right.
I guess two
swords.
So yeah. I walk up the stairs. I take it two at a time because I hate stairs. Like, I always run up the stairs.
Stop.
You always run upstairs?
Well, like, don't run. Just, like, I jump, like, two at like, a time until, like, I get to the top.
Alright, so you get to the top.
I get to the top.
Alright. What would you like to do?
Well, I'd like to see where I'm at. 13, 17.
Alright. So, you see, you and Lead see this first. There's a suit of black plate armor standing at the against the wall. And you see, the third floor, there's, once you get to the top, there's a door to your left. There's the suit of armor in the center wall, and a double door to your right. And then, beside it, there's another single door. Yeah.
Okay.
So there's... three doors and a suit of armor. You see that there are oil lamps, like, mounted on the wall. And, you know, that beautiful carved woodland scene.
Yeah.
With, you know, tiny critters and trees and falling leaves.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful
cartoon
stuff.
Critters, Bambi.
And, Yeah, so, you know, it's just along the paneling.
Yeah, the backyard again.
All right, then, since it's a nice big open room,
I'm sorry, what was that roll number again?
17.
When you're getting... Oh, when you're going upstairs, you also notice, with a closer eye on the paneling, they're hanging from these trees are tiny corpses.
Again, it's more demonic, like,
pictures. And worms bursting up from the ground. Yeah, along this, like, carved into the wall.
Funny how you don't notice these things on a first look.
They're all mahogany colored.
This is kind of reminiscent
of
the letter that it got. The worms writhing in the earth.
Is that by Escher?
So we
all
into the room.
Hey, well, I switched over to Blade, considering it's a bigger room.
She was at 17?
I call this one.
Yeah.
Old, you also notice beside that door to the left, there's something wrong with the wall beside it.
There's something wrong with
the wall.
So, like, directly to the left?
You know the door on the left?
Yeah.
There's something wrong with the wall beside it.
Well, I'll go inspect that then.
A sponge ball.
Yeah, okay.
A beauty.
So,
see.
What do you do?
Probably see something right now.
Like, it's wrong? How? Explain wrong.
You see, you know, you give a little push on the wall, and it opens. It starts to move back, as if it was a door. Like a secret door, almost.
Okay.
So the wall starts to move if you apply pressure.
Alright.
Yeah.
Well, in that case, I'll just take my foot, and place it against the wall. Like, guys, I found something! And push in.
Alright. You see, it's a wooden staircase that goes up. Also take note that the stairwell ends. It does not continue to the fourth floor.
No.
But there's a dusty cobweb-filled stairwell that goes up.
Okay, well...
Let's go up.
Well, no, we still got three rooms here to look at. Alright.
I'll go up. I go up.
Alright, oh, so you're going up?
I'll go
you're
up.
Going up
he
alone
said,
by
and
yourself before
I'm
we...
I'm going to check out the suit of armor.
Not yet.
Okay.
I want to look at these other things.
So
I want to look at that suit of armor.
What are you going to do?
That
actually,
black plate mail that you were saying, well, how does it, like, how does it look?
He's gonna inspect it.
Well, he can't, well, I guess you just...
Well, like, I just
want to
know how it looks, like, how good
well, he
it
was
looks.
Opening up the room,
okay.
So...
Yeah.
Yeah. On your next turn, you can go back to it.
I know, but just how did it look?
It was, a beautifully well-crafted suit of black metal plate armor.
It was
ooh,
beautifully
hey,
crafted, but everything else
good.
Was...
Tarnished and awful.
Alright.
So you're going up to the Fuck attic, Theodane. Do you want to check out the third floor or go up?
I would,
It's usually magic items
I'll
don't
go...
get
go... The third floor is the one with the three rooms and the suit of armor.
Can you say that, though?
No. That's it.
And there's a dusty cobweb
I look at it, I'm looking at it
up.
Weird, because, like, I'm still there.
Take the dusty cobweb stay and go up with you.
Okay.
Guys, wait for us to check these rooms. What if there's anything in these rooms?
So these three are going
up.
These three are going up. You two remain on the third floor.
Hey guys, just stay here until we like check out these rooms and we'll all go up together.
It's too late. They are up the stairs.
No, like I'm at the stairs. I'm talking to him before he went up.
It might
but
be a good idea
up.
For me to stick down.
And you went back to the armor.
Yeah.
And I went up too.
So, anyways.
It's too late.
Third
oh,
floor.
To the armor. Okay.
Two parts. So you guys are at the armor.
The
what would you like to do?
Campaign.
I'm gonna see if it has any weapons on it.
It does. A big sword.
Is it holding it?
Yes.
Okay, I'm not gonna touch it. any other weapons around?
Not around the room, no.
Okay.
Maybe nope. No, there's nothing around the room. It's just like a hallway, but there's just a suit of armor with.